Yeah, hello everyone, good day and welcome once again. If you dey watch me for YouTube, welcome to Hamdes TV. And if you dey watch me for Facebook, welcome to Joy Sidan. Yes, my lovely people, today we want to discuss about the matter, the issue concerning Maze Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Wembe IPOB, and the entire Biafra nation. Yes, my lovely people, the matter when they run now, when they be say, the federal government don't inject Maze Nnamdi Kanu. Yes, they don't inject them for the DSS custody when in day. And now they don't allow any medical investigation into the injection where they give them, so for them to at least to investigate to know the kind of injection where they give Maze Nnamdi Kanu. As the matter they go now, the indigenous people of Biafra, when be IPOB, they don't declare state of emergency for inside the southeast because of the way when the Maze Nnamdi Kanu heads they go. As the matter they run now, Maze Nnamdi Kanu, you know, they okay at all, at all, at all. Yes, you know, they okay. And according to the lawyer, when be Ejimakor, you don't still let the whole world know, say, the kind of treatment, the kind of human treatment when they give Maze Nnamdi Kanu, it can they worsen a health condition. Because since 4 months now, when Maze Nnamdi Kanu did for DSS custody, they never even allow him change clothes. 4 months. 4 months. He they wear only one cloth for good 4 months. So I believe when I know the kind of thing when that from me say he not good at all, at all. And also they say that they keep him for one small tiny room. For more than 2 weeks, he go there for one small tiny room. He not get anybody to interact with, no television, no radio, no people to talk to. And secondly, he they sleep for ordinary ground, ordinary floor, even without pillow. They not allow him to independently get his own access to any of his doctor for them to give him checkup concerning the way when in health condition day. And Maze Nnamdi Kanu, his lawyer be done demand several times, say, the DSS custody, the torture when they give him for them, because they torture him, that they beat him, that they treat him badly. So, if you don't demand, say, may they transfer Maze Nnamdi Kanu to Kuje prison when they for inside Lagos. But still, the federal government, they refuse, say, they no go leave him, make it go Kuje prison. And the matana, the way when they go, it not good at all, at all, at all. So, because of all these ones now, and the one when worsen for inside Nana, because say, the Nigerian government now don't still give them injection when anybody don't know the kind of injection when they give them. Okay, may they grant them access now so that at least in doctors go come investigate, say, which kind of injection when I give them, they not allow all this investigation. So, I believe, say, the way when the matter they go, it not good at all, at all. So, all that one, now make the indigenous people of Biafra, now make the con declare state of emergency for inside Biafra land. And the other one, when stick on the thread, be say, the people of, that is the elder of Igbo, of Biafran people, when be the elders, you know, all these old men, when Sabi Waka for the matter, even politicians, they inside the matter, some, what thing that they call the whether na father, been a pope, been a pastors, me, I never can understand. All those ones, see, they inside the matter, all of them Waka, they carry their leg, go meet Buhari, come tell Buhari, say, to make peace reign, he need to release Maze Nnamdi Kanu to them unconditionally so that at least peace go reign. Because the way where the thing they go now, business when they for southeast, everything don't close down, nothing they move at all, at all. So make we like, make we read and comment how the elders of the Biafran people, how the Waka go for Abuja. According to the issue, Mr. Kanu, a leader of the outlawed separatist group IPOB, is being detained and persecuted on treason charges. When we say he not the work at all, at all, we don't know the kind of treason charges when they give her. And the group of Igbo leaders on Friday, when be 19th of November 2020, they meet with President Muhammadu Buhari, during which they ask him for the release of Maze Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally. According to the statement when they talk, Mr. Buhari, when speak through a spokesperson, when be Mr. Adesina, he told his guests that An unconditional release of Mr. Kanu runs contrary to the doctrine of separations of powers between the executive and judiciaries. Welcome me say the unconditional of Mazinamdi Kanu release when they ask say it they contrary and which means say in not they together is a they apart of the doctrine of separation of powers and the between executive or judiciary, like the courts now when they carry and go. So then they be want make the courts take justice to the matter. But as the matter they go now, they be doing when they wait for court again, because always now they don't they postpone the case. Even up to now, they don't still postpone the case till on 19th of January 2021. And you can imagine person when they for inside prison, inside DSS custody, not be even prison said, because DSS custody it was past prison. When they put DSS custody for good 4 months, he never changed clothes. And they give him injection when he don't know. They not allow him to for doctors to visit him. They not allow his families to visit him as they want. Then they keep him for one room, you know. They beat him, they maltreat him. So I don't believe say Nigerian government they get any fair justice when they won't give Mazinamdi Kanu. So for them to talk about doctrine and executive and judiciaries, I believe say that one, you know, they work again, I know they work at all. So as the leaders now, the Biafran leaders come meet President Muhammadu Buhari, contend and say, really they need to release Mazinamdi Kanu to them. So Buhari replies, he said the request when they want. The unconditional release of Mazinamdi Kanu, leader of the outlawed indigenous people of Biafra IPOB, currently standing trial, runs contrary to doctrine of separation of powers between the executive and the judiciary, President Muhammadu Buhari said. Receiving a group under the aegis of a high respected Igbo great, led by First Republic parliamentarian and minister of aviation chief, Mbazulike Amechi, at State House Abuja, the president told the 93-year-old Wemby Amechi, he tell and say, he don't make a very difficult demand on the release of the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Wemby Nnamdi Kanu. So he said, you made an extreme difficult demand on me as leader of this country. The implication of your request is very serious. In the last 6 years since I became president, nobody would say I have confronted or interfered in the work of the judiciaries. If they tell them, say, the demand when they ask, if they hard, well, and if they difficult, because nobody go talk, say, since 6 years when he be president, say, he don't interfere into the judiciaries, like all these judge, the lawyers, the court, the cases when they for court. So, which means now courts need to carry out their case, maybe him. So, he said, God has spared you and giving you a clear heart, a clear hand at this age with very sharp memory. So they congratulate and make it say, God don't spare him, he don't give him at least a clear head, and God don't still give him a very sharp memory. He said, a lot of people half of your age are confused already, but the demand you made is very heavy, I will consider it. He can't let Amechi know, say, half of them, half of the mates, when half of the guys, people when he be say they get half of his age, a lot of them don't confuse. The demand when he told, he asked them to do, to release Mazinamdi Kanu, it is very heavy, but Ingo consider him. Stressing his policy of non-interference with the judiciary, President Muhammadu Buhari said, when Kanu jumped bail, got arrested and brought back to the country, I said the best thing was to subject him to the system, let him make his case in court instead of giving very negative impression of the country from outside. I feel it's even a favor to give him that opportunity. Which kind of favor? To give him which opportunity for inside court? Because we never see anything, any crime when Mazinamdi Kanu commit. And since now, when if you won't give him at least that good opportunity, since when you give him that opportunity when he there for DSS custody, when he they go court, nothing, no case, nothing when did they happen for court. They just, they carry and they come court, they carry and now they go back to that their DSS custody. Whether they get waiting there for their plan, we don't know. So we not feel agree with that one, say that one a good opportunity for them, because we not say for that Nigeria country, there is no fair justice for anybody when it be say they expose the secrets of the government, if they talk of the bad things when the government they do, or the evils when they happen for inside the country. So we not support that one, say really you give them that good opportunity, because that one be opportunity. 4 months now he don't spend for inside prison, still they never even judge the case, nothing. They still they postpone them, they go. Even in health condition, they don't even grant him access to his doctors to come treat him. So we not see how that one can be fair justice. The president condone with Chief Amechi. Bin like say Chief Amechi lose his wife of recent. So according to them, they said the non-Nigerian had described the situation in the southeast as painful and pathetic, lamenting that businesses have collapsed, education is crumbling, and there is fear everywhere. So the people Amechi and the group went go visit Muhammadu Buhari. They let Buhari, they know say the businesses when they for southeast, everything don't crumble. Even for the education issue, everything don't work again. Business don't collapse, education don't crumble, and fear day everywhere. So he pleaded for a political rather than military solution. So in the accent, say they need to discuss politically rather than sending soldiers to the southeast to be killing innocent people, requesting that if Kanu was released to him as the only First Republic minister still alive, he would no longer say the things he had been saying, stressing that he could control him. Not because I have anything to do with them, IPO, but I am highly respected in Igbo land today. So Amechi dey let say Muhammadu Buhari dey know say if he release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu to Ram, he no go dey talk of the things when he be say he dey talk before. And the people of Biafran people, they respect him. It be like it, that, which means say Mazina and the Kanu go still hear in voice if he still talk to her. So Chief Amechi said twice he had interfered with Nnamdi Kanu in the past, and the letter resided under earlier giving on civilian disobedience. He concluded, he said, I don't want to leave this planet without peace returning to my country. I believe in one big united Nigeria, a force in Africa. Mr. President, I want you to be remembered as a person who saw Nigeria burning and you quenched the fire. Other people in the visiting delegation were His Excellency Chukwuemeka Ezeafe, former governor of Anambra State, Bishop Sunday Onoha of the Methodist Church, Chief Barrister Godi Owazurike, former president of Igbo Social Cultural Group, Aka Ikenga, and Mr. Tagbo Mbazulike Amechi. So now these people now then go visit them. Visit Muhammadu Buhari, they tell and say they need making release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu unconditionally, so that peace go reign, so that businesses and schools go come back to normal ways. So in the let Buhari, they understand, say he don't want make it die, make it leave this planet without making peace to reign in the country. Say for him, he believe united Nigeria as in Toko. As for him, maybe he's not seeing what people are seeing, he's not seeing the danger, but maybe he still wants that unity between Nigeria and the Biafrans. And when he come be say the unity, he get as he be, because he be like say the Fulani henchmen, they don't interfere into that unity. When be say it provoke many Biafrans come the verse, because of the way when the Fulani henchmen and the Boko Haram till they kill Christians and the Biafran people. So my lovely people, this now the matter will carry come today. So we dey ask Nigerian government to please allow medical investigation, make them for take control and investigate the kind injection where they give Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. So myself, I can't wonder, say after the injection, now the elders of the Igbos, now they can't come out, can't say they won't make the release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Why they not talking before the injection? And make them make sure, say that injection where they give Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, maybe the injection when go kill him, maybe the injection when go cause harm to his body system. So may they be very, very careful so that they will not cause more chaos in that particular country called Nigeria. So my people, that is it. I'll leave now. Make una watch the video how they take waka for Abuja, the Biafran leaders and Muhammadu Buhari. Thank you all and remain blessed. If you never subscribe to our YouTube channel, please subscribe to my subscribers. I thank you all. God bless you. Those who never see, they follow us on Facebook, please do. And to my followers, my subscribers, my likers, my sharers, may God continue to bless you now. So thank you, my lovely viewers, and remain blessed. Make sure you share. Bye for now.
This is the first group of visitors the president would be meeting after receiving the American Secretary of State at the presidential villa upon his return from an official trip. The group, under the aegis of highly respected Igbo greats, is led by First Republic parliamentarian and former Minister of Aviation, Chief Mbazulike Amechi. The situation in the southeast, which he describes as painful and pathetic, is an increase in concern, he laments to the president. He is asking that the president considers a political rather than military solution to the situation and release the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mr. Nnamdi Kanu, to him to save businesses and the education sector from utter collapse in the region. He assures that he would exert control over the IPOB leader as a highly respected man in Igboland. Having heard the submissions, the president admits that making a decision is difficult, but he would consider the group's request. According to a statement released by the special advisor to the president on media and publicity, Mr. Femi Adesina, the president says that the group has made an extremely difficult demand on him as leader of the country. In his words, the implication of your request is very serious. In the last 6 years since I became president, nobody would say I have confronted or interfered in the work of the judiciary. God has spared you and given you a clear head at this age with very sharp memory. A lot of people half your age are confused already, but the demand you have made is heavy. I will consider it. It would be recalled that last month, the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Mr. Abubakar Malami, had also alluded to a flexible stance on the matter when he stated that the federal government is open to all kinds of considerations, including a political solution as part of efforts to resolve the crisis surrounding separatist agitations in the southeast and the southwest parts of the country. It is expected that more reactions will trail this consideration, which is the first openly made by the president. Gloria Umezuke, Channels Television News.